exciting day?
A wonderful day.
Fruitful day.
Very fruitful. Thank you so much.
Let's talk about Mmabana and, you know, the relationship with the disability sports.
Yeah, thanks. In terms of the mandate of Mmabana, we've got an obligation to identify, develop and support talent, inclusive of people with disabilities. So today is so special that we have partnered with the Confederation to deliver programs in as far as sports is concerned to make sure that people with disabilities form part of the mainstream of the programs. Okay. In Mmabana, we offer programs such as aerobics, tumbling, karate, gymnastics, bodybuilding, circuit training. So today we'll ensure that we intensify on the programs, especially including people with disabilities. The opportunity is there for us to expand to other programs such as pool, table tennis, and so forth. So today marks a very important day wherein we are going to change the landscape and make sure that the disability sector is part of the mainstream as services within Mmabana context.
What would you like people to take out of today's event?
Look, the partnership, if you look at how the federation is, the confederation is structured, it's got 53 members. Now, every affiliate would now know that there's Mmabana, and the people with disabilities would be able to access services across all Mmabanas in Northwest. We've got a center in Rustenburg, in Lehurutse, in Taung, in Mafikeng, and we'll be commencing programs in Dr. KK. So the real message is, as we celebrate on the awareness in terms of disability, access to programs by people with disabilities is going to be enabled, and that's how significant today is to them as a sector.
Let's look at the future of disability sports, especially in Mmabana and also in the Northwest.
We would agree that statistically, we are aware of the percentage of the persons with disability in the country and the Northwest.
Yes.
But access to services has been hindered by various factors, whether being stigmatization, whether being infrastructure, whether being lack of knowledge and exposure.
Sure.
Now, the future is one, we're going to have this ongoing collaborations with the Confederation. We have just agreed in plenary that we'll be hosting another event in February.
Wonderful.
And the future is that we are looking at three areas. Mmabana will be running a program on sports administration for people with disabilities. So we'll go out, seek funding, advertise for learnerships, put people on a 12-month program, NQF level 4, 5 accredited, train them as sports administrators so that they can begin, you know, to have an influence in the fraternity in as far as their role is concerned. Secondly, we'll be looking at infrastructure improvement. We don't have a single high-performance center for people with disability in the country, so we want to get into that space as Mmabana, go out, engage with the donors, and make sure that we start moving towards creating a center. It's so bad that when you've got athletes coming from this province, as the case is with one of us who's in Cape Town now for preparation for performances at an international level, we don't have facilities. So our real future is we must now look at infrastructure development, invest significantly so that the sector can access services. I think that's the real impact. And by so doing, we'll be enhancing and enabling access by people with disability, ensure that we remove the barriers, comply with the policy on reasonable accommodation, and make sure that they are as comfortable as possible, and they compete equally, and they should not be looked down upon because of their status of disability.
You know, because we're running out of time, as a father, as a community member in the country, in the Northwest, especially Mmabana, how else could you encourage people with disability to take part in activities that Mmabana is, you know, putting out in terms of opportunities?
In plenary now, in performances, one of the ways of encouraging, we've got little kids from a special school around here. We have identified them as Mmabana. We put them through a program. They have delivered a wonderful performance today. So, So you can't encourage people differently. They need to go to the nearest facilities of Mmabana, participate in the programs, and this group that I'm speaking about, which is from local here, we will be taking them to Sun City. There's a program that will be running from the 16th of December to the 10th of January.
Okay.
I have made a commitment that this group will be provided with uniform, with transport, with accommodation, and we'll be taking them to Sun City to showcase that people with disability are equally competent. And I encourage every single parent to expose the little ones with disability to lots of information.
Yes.
Let's not keep them in the house and hide them away. Let's make sure that they get exposure and we can get the talent, identify and support them. And it's our responsibility, all of us as a nation, to make sure that we protect the sector.
I'm so happy that we made it here today. I can't wait for the February event. I'm hoping that we'll get the next invite to actually, you know, see the upgrade from here and how far we have reached people within the Northwest, especially in Taung. Thank you so much, CEO, for actually joining us. It's been a pleasure.
We'll invite you. We've got the Mmabana Talent Search Program, the 5th, the 12th, 19th December. It will be district competitions. The 26th of December, it will be in Mafikeng Provincial Competition.
Wonderful.
We'll keep in touch with you as a stakeholder. Thank you so much.
We're excited. All right, that is literally the wrap of UFM Star 40. We were live at Mmabana in Taung. Remember, we're still celebrating disability.